here. Welcome to the seat. Let's get creative.
Welcome back, guys. Today we're going to get creative with textile art. You're going to need your tote bag, your fabric sticks, and fabric paint. You're also going to need a cardstock. We're going to make a stencil out of this. So grab a pair of scissors, a pencil, your fabric paint, a sponge. If you don't have a sponge, I can also use cotton balls. Or if you have a really thick, coarse, bristled paintbrush, that works really well with making stencils too. Take your cardstock and fold it in half. Now I want you to draw half of a shape. Here we're starting to sketch out a leaf shape, but we're only going to be drawing half of it because we folded the paper, and on the fold, we're going to draw our design going outside towards the edge of the paper. You don't have to do a leaf shape. You can choose to draw any shape you want. Some ideas would be maybe half a star or a love heart. Or instead of folding your paper, you could just draw a design on your paper and cut it out and use that. So you don't have to fold it and make a symmetrical shape. So an object may be a guitar or a car. The most important thing is you want to keep this shape basic. You don't want it too intricate or detailed because it's going to be really tricky to cut it out and then to trace it with your fabric paint or sticks. So keep it really basic and simple. The simple geometric shapes work the best. So go ahead and cut your design out and open your paper out, and you're gonna lay it on top of your tote bag. So now take your piece of cardboard or your scrap piece of paper and slide it on the inside of your tote bag to protect it from the colors bleeding through. Here we're making another interesting design for the border of our bag. If you'd like to follow along, what you need is just a rectangle piece of paper and fold that in half. Now on the fold, I'm drawing two triangles pointing up and then another triangle pointing down. But notice you don't see the tip of that middle triangle. You'll see why in a second. Draw that design and carefully cut on the fold. So when you open it up, you have a really cool border pattern that we're gonna put on the bottom. You'll see. You can also buy beautiful intricate patterns from your local craft shop. Here we have a really pretty, it's like a mandala flower. These are really awesome because they're plastic and reusable. And so you can put them on your bag and multiple surfaces and use them over and over again. Now it's time to place your cardboard inside the bag, and let's put your main stencil on top. You want to hold it down nice and tight when you're doing it. Now I'm just going to be using the paintbrush. But again, you can use your sponge or the cotton swab. Because I'm using a leaf pattern, I'm gonna be using some nice autumn colors. You can choose whatever colors you would like. You can even mix and match. So holding your stencil down nice and tightly, I'm gonna start with red in the middle, and I'm gonna slowly transition into orange and then yellow. As you're applying the paint, I want you to use a dabbing technique. So you're pouncing your brush or your cotton swab or sponge up and down, instead of brushing like a normal paintbrush. You're bouncing onto your fabric. So that's gonna force all of that color paint into the fibers of the canvas tote. Have fun using a variety of colors. You can see what happens when you apply a color on top of another color. You can even take your fingers and kind of blend the two together. Continue this process until your entire stencil is filled in with color. Carefully take the stencil up without moving or shifting because you don't want to smudge that paint on the edges. Now, if there's any other stencils you'd like to try, follow that process by holding down the stencil nice and tight, using your sponge and dabbing or pressing hard into that canvas. Remember, if you're making another stencil, you're going to have to move that cardboard from the inside of your bag down or over, so you protect the paint from bleeding through to the backside. If you want to try practicing with new shapes and stencils, that's totally cool. Grab a scrap piece of paper, draw your design, or you can fold your paper and just start cutting. You can also practice on scrap paper by putting your stencil on top of a scrap piece of paper or on the back and seeing what the stencil looks like before committing and putting your design on the canvas tote. The problem with using normal paper is it gets really flimsy and floppy when you add anything with moisture. So just keep that in mind. It's a one-time stencil. You won't be able to reuse it as the paper may start to curl like our stencil here. Now I'm going to grab a tiny brush and I'm gonna do some details on top of my leaf. I want this to look like an autumn tree. So I'm gonna use some black fabric paint. I'm gonna use a really skinny fine brush. This is a round brush, so it's nice and pointy. If you'd like to use a tiny bit of water on your brush, you can dab it into your paint and add some fine lines. It looks very effective if you use black paint and do some details on top of your design. So no matter what shape you have, it might be interesting to do a black pattern or some nice details to make it stand out. If you don't want to use black, you can use any color paint. Just keep in mind, you want the color that you put on top to be a contrasting color, which means the color behind it, you want it to be either a lighter shade and the color on top a darker, or vice versa. So using a contrasting color, it allows those other colors to pop and stand out. So that's why we're going to use the black paint on top of all those bright, warm colors. Now I'm going to do a fine black outline around this tree to make it stand out. Have fun adding fine lines and details to your design and see how you can change it and make it more effective. If you want some really skinny lines, it helps if you don't put a lot of pressure on your brush. So to get those little fine lines, you're going to use really slow, light pressured lines to get really skinny marks. The more pressure that you put on your brush, the fatter the lines are going to be. Have a practice on a little piece of paper and see if you can get some really fine lines and some really thick lines and see which ones you like. Once you have your design painted, you're going to very carefully shimmy out that cardboard or move it to another place so you can add more details. Mistakes happen to everyone, even the pros. Don't worry, your design isn't ruined. You can turn these happy little accidents into new designs. We accidentally added a dab of black paint, but we're gonna turn that into our artist's signature. So remember, if you do make a mistake, your design isn't ruined. You can always turn it into something new. Add a new stencil on top of a mistake, or you can hide it with some glue and sequins. Here we're gonna slowly move that cardboard up to the top, and now we're gonna move on to our fabric sticks. This is my new favorite product. These fabric sticks are really cool, similar to oil pastels because you can blend the colors and they're super soft. So when you start to use these fabric sticks, don't wind them up too fast or else they'll squish down to the bottom and you'll ruin them. Here we're going to draw our name on the top. If you'd like to practice to find the middle of your name, go ahead and write your name on a scrap piece of paper. Find the middle letter, and then you can write that middle letter on the middle of your bag. So here we're writing the letter A because we're writing Sam and A is the middle letter. Then you write the letters to the right and then to the left. So you're always working from the center outward. We're gonna start with blue and then we're gonna overlap into a new color. So you can choose what colors you want. We wanted to show you the different combination of colors. So here we're using the cool colors on the top. Blues, greens, and purples are cool colors, and they contrast with the warm colors from the tree. You don't have to choose those color schemes, but choose something interesting and have fun. Keep in mind that these fabric sticks create a thick line versus the really skinny painted line. So when you're doing your words or your designs, don't try to draw something really small or too tiny with details because these fabric sticks are really fat. So they're gonna give you really bold lines. It would be really fun to see you maybe use your fabric sticks and draw some swirly or wavy lines or possibly some zigzag lines to give an effect or maybe even a border going around your bag. When you're finished using them, wind them down and put the cap back on tightly. Now these fabric sticks are paint, so they are going to be a little bit damp. The way that you set all of these fabric paints and stick designs is by putting a clean piece of paper on top that's gonna cover your design, and then you're gonna take your cotton setting on your iron and do a heat set. It only takes a few minutes to set the color in, but once you do, they're washable. So you can use these fabric sticks on t-shirts, on shoes, on another tote bag. The possibilities are endless. That's why this product is one of my favorites. You can have fun adding some glue and the sequins, or you can use the glitter glue, or have fun with the fabric sticks and add more patterns and designs. When you're finished, make sure you heat set it and you're ready to go. Thanks for joining us, guys. I hope you enjoyed using the fabric paint and fabric sticks on your tote bag. We would love to see your designs. If you can, you can tag us at TheSeedCW on Instagram or Facebook, and we'll be able to see your colorful designs. Again, thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Bye.